Day like today. We had a glorious time last night at PB. Over 600 people attended his service last night. I told somebody, I said, I don't know anything about it, but I don't believe I can draw the crowd. Ronnie Smart is drawing. Appreciate him, love him. He is a brother of the Lord, but he feels like a brother. Natural. Just been on memory lane the last several days, and I certainly am today. The last time I stood in the pulpit at this church, I was about 20 years old. The first time I was 18, so back 48 years. I'm so happy for all of you that are here.
Pleasant good morning to all of you. We're here again today to celebrate the life of our dear friend, Ronnie Smart, 67, lived in BB, was born to Reuben and Luella Young Smart, January 25th, 1947. As I mentioned last evening, we were so grateful. It was just a few days ago to be there with him. He was crowned with great glory, June 27th. 2014. He was a member of Lighthouse Pentecostal Church in BB, Arkansas, a member of the Apostolic Ministers Fellowship. All of you probably know, maybe even better than some of us who didn't know him early in life, that Brother Ronnie Smart was dramatically visually impaired, but he did not let that keep him from working for God. He worked in spite of his difficulties and was very involved in reaching all over the country. I know many of you were not able to be there last evening. Outpouring of love and support from the preachers literally all over the country that drove in and shared their love and respect for this good man. And the other thing that I wanted to mention is that even in recent days, exactly 5 days before he collapsed with the illness that led him to his death, he was about to master's business that Tuesday. He was preparing to go and baptize a couple of people at the White County Detention Center. I received word that he was planning to do that, but wasn't feeling the greatest. And so I said, well, I'd love to go. And so I decided to go, and somebody let him know that. He called and left me a voicemail and told me how much he appreciated me doing that. But he said, I sure would have gone if you couldn't, because I want to make sure they're able to do that. It was very important to him. He survived by his wife, Joyce Smart, to follow his hand, two sisters, Linda Horn and Donna Crabtree. Here at Sulphur Rock, numerous nieces, nephews, cousins, and other extended family that I haven't had the pleasure of meeting all of you, but hopefully I will before we leave today or in the near future. It's definitely been a very special experience for me individually, and I know for my family to become more acquainted with all of you. It's a special thing that I hope this is not the end of just maybe a rekindling of old friendships that we've had off and on throughout the years. The other day, for those of you who may not know, we're gathered around the bed. We sang a lot of songs, and Brenda shared with me that her favorite song to hear him sing, I hadn't heard him sing in a while.